Today, I'm bringing to you one of the most nostalgic recipes from our childhood. I'm making Aam Papad today. Let's see how to make it. Mangoes can be super unpredictable. Sometimes they look ripe, but they don't taste as sweet as you would want them to. In that case, you can definitely make Aam Papad out of them. But you can also use sweet mangoes or a mix of both if you like. So I'm going to start by pureeing some mangoes over here. I have around 3.5 mangoes, which comes to about 1.5 cups. These are chopped up mangoes. There's usually a lot of wastage on the mangoes around the seeds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pulp these out from the seeds and then I'm going to use them in the Aam Papad as well. We're going to add the pulp to our mixer and we're going to grind this all together. I'm going to sieve the mixture just to make sure there are no threads of mango in our Aam Papad. I'm just going to run it through the sieve. Time to cook our mango puree. I'm just going to add it very wide pan along with 4 tablespoons of sugar. Now, depending on the sweetness of your mango, you can add a little more or a little less of the sugar. Now we're going to cook this for at least 5 to 10 minutes. Make sure you stir all along and keep the flame from low to medium so that it doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan. Our Aam Papad mixture is now ready. Here's how you can tell whether it's ready or not. Switch off the flame, let the bubbles subside, mix it once, and then run your spatula through the center. If the mixture stays as it is and it doesn't run through and join again, the Aam Papad mixture is ready. Now I'm going to flavor this into a chatpata mixture. I'm going to add a little bit of red chilli powder. This is around 1/4 teaspoon. You can increase the spiciness if you like. Amchur powder to make it a little sour. And a small pinch of salt just to balance all the flavors out. You can also add jeera powder if you like. But I don't want to change the color a lot. So I'm just avoiding it this time. I'm going to set the Aam Papad on a steel plate. You can use any plate of your choice. You can also use a silicone mat or a baking sheet if you want. Now I'm going to brush this with a little bit of ghee just to ensure that the Aam Papad comes out very simply once it's ready. Now I'm going to add the mixture into the plate and I'm just going to spread the mixture around directly so that it stays even. You can also tap the tray a little to get rid of any air bubbles. And if you notice there's a spot wherein you can see the tray a little, just spoon it over and tap it once again. So there are a few ways in which you can set the Aam Papad. The first one is to let it dry under the sun for a couple of days. But in this method, what happens is there's a lot of dust that can stick to your Aam Papad. In that case, you can just cover this with a very thin cloth that lets air through it. And then you can let it dry under the sun for a couple of days. The second way to dry it is under the ceiling fan. So you can just place it on your dining table, let the fan run overnight, and then check it every day to make sure that it is dry or not. Once it's dry, you can just scrape it out and enjoy it. The third way is the quickest way. We're going to dry this in the oven at a very low temperature of about 50 degrees Celsius, nothing more than that. And we're going to let it go for about 2 to 3 hours and your Aam Papad will be ready on the same day itself. It took about 3 hours for the Aam Papad to dry up completely in a 50 degrees Celsius oven. And now it's ready to consume. I'm just going to cut it up. Make this Aam Papad this summer and relive all your childhood memories. Let me know how it turns out in the comment section below. I'm Chef Bhumika signing off from Rajshri Food.